Imagine a world where textures aren't confined to static image files, but instead they are dynamically generated through the magic of algorithms. That's the sense of procedural materials, and in this video tutorial we are diving into the captivating realm of procedural materials in Blender. Here I have two objects, this one with image texture material which I can try to create, but this one is procedural. Alright, I delete this material, add a new principal BSDF, and let's start from scratch. The first step is to create a texture for displacement. This will be a basic texture for procedural material. I start with Voronoi texture. Press Ctrl-Shift and click on the node to see how this texture looks on the object, and press Ctrl-T to add a texture coordinate. I would like to use object instead of normal because I don't want to use an unwrap in this case. In general, I don't need the mapping node, but I leave this node here. If I would like to change to normal to use an unwrap model, it will help me. So I leave it here for now. Return to Voronoi texture. I can adjust the value to get a contrast texture, which will be the base texture. But it doesn't look like a stone, and I need another node, noise texture, which I put before Voronoi texture to impact the results of Voronoi texture. And we need to change the settings of noise texture to this. Now it looks closer to stone displacement texture. So I leave these two nodes as a basic, and we need to connect them to principal BSDF. I need bump and displacement. I will return to bump, but now we keep going creating material with displacement only. Connect this setup to the displacement node. Boom! It already looks good, like a stone. So move ahead, and if we look at this example material, we can see some dents here and here. Let's try to make this in our procedural material. To do this, I open Voronoi texture. I immediately change the value to my prepared ones. If you want, you can experiment. Also, we need to connect this Voronoi texture with texture coordinate. Now this texture looks so uniform, we need to distort it. To do this, I place noise texture before Voronoi texture and change the settings to something like this. Now it looks not so uniform, but still not like a natural stone. We need another node to mix with this setup. I add mask grave texture and change settings. And we need to mix everything. Connect Voronoi texture to A and mask grave texture to B. Using factor, we can achieve the same natural noise. It's a little bit visible, but it will be working well. I add another one noise texture. And again mix everything with color node. Now it's ready. Let's add a color ramp to make more contrast to this texture. If I move black and white points closer to each other, I can get this effect, which will be responsible for this dance. See how it works. Now we need to connect this node setup with previous node combinations for displacement. To do this, I need mix color, but I have to put this one before the displacement node. Connect this to factor and this one to color B. And see what we got. If I change a color in this mix node, I can impact how contrast my displacement texture will be. Also, I can use this color ramp node to erode some spots, making it sharp or softer to get more natural effect. Alright, now let's add a color to our procedural material. To do this, I need a mix color node, but I start with noise texture to have an opportunity to make a variety of color combinations. Color ramp to bring more contrast to the texture. But instead of using linear, I will use B-spline. This makes the texture more softer, and I add a mix color, but I would like to use this noise texture as a factor. Now I have the opportunity to combine color and get natural stone effect. Of course, I need to make different colors to this dance, and I wanna make them darker than the base color. I need another mix color. For this one, I connect to color B and going to use texture related to this dance as a factor. Now I can impact these spots using a color B. Connect to the principal BSDF and see how it works. Okay, look at our reference once more, and we can see some small white rocks. Let's try to recreate these effects on our procedural texture. I add Voronoi texture to the shader editor and connect with texture coordinate. Make a large scale. Press Ctrl Shift and click on the texture to see this texture on the object. I need small dots for my purpose as we see now, but it's so artificial. To make it more like a natural rock, I add noise texture before this Voronoi texture and change the settings to make it more reminiscent of some small rocks. Of course, we need a color ramp node to make contrast texture. I would like to use this combination as a mask for my base color and displacement, but we need to invert this texture. Connect to the principal BSDF, and we also need to add this texture to displacement. To do this, I will use another mix color node, which I placed before displacement node, and connect this texture to A and this one to B, and connect to the main displacement texture. Organize a little bit of connection between nodes and see what we have. Using this way, I added another rock, and you may experiment with it to achieve a realistic result by adding as many details as you need. Just don't forget to organize everything so as not to get confused in the future. Once again, look at our reference, and we may see here some light spots that make texture more natural. Let's try to do the same. I add mask grave texture, and I'm going to use this texture as a mask where I would like to see some light spots. Connect to the base material, and using the color, I can do some light parts. Also, we may use a color ramp to make these parts sharper. Looks nice, isn't it? As you remember, I added bump node at the beginning, so now we use it and add to our procedural texture some small bump details. Again, using noise texture. Change the settings and connect to the bump node. It's affected too much, so I decrease the high value and add a color ramp to make this texture a little bit flat. Some kind of like this. I also can decrease the scale of displacement. So yeah, it looks like what I need. Alright, we need to work with roughness. To do this, I'm going to use this displacement texture to have some reflections related to my main stone texture. But I add a hue saturation node to have an opportunity to control roughness. If I change the value, I can add more roughness effect or decrease it depending on my goals. Also, this will be necessary for me when I will be gathering everything into one group material. Finally, let's add ambient occlusion to our procedural material. This will add such a clip at the corner and intersection of the geometry. I need an ambient occlusion knot and color ramp to connect everything with the base texture. Use ambient occlusion and surfactor. So using a color ramp, I can soften or sharpen this effect. See how it works. By the way, it might not be only dark, but also light, some dust effect, whatever you need related to your goals. Alright, this is what procedural materials look like, and I suggest gathering everything into one useful knot to make opportunities to change settings without searching through the whole of these knots. It's simple. Just select everything and press Ctrl-G. Now we have one small knot instead of bunch of them, but we don't have a settings here. To do this, I open Tab to open this group. And we need to connect all parameters that we want to use in our group node to group input here. Depending on your goals and wishes, you may connect all necessary values that you need, but I definitely want to use the colors, scales of important parts like small rocks and the color of ambient occlusion. Also, I need displacement and bump as a scale settings of them. Just don't forget to name everything in the group input settings. So this is my group knot of procedural stone material, which I may use in my other project, just append it to other Blender scene, or use it as an asset on a Blender asset browser. If you want to know more about how to use Blender asset browser, I have a full video on my channel, link in the corner. Unlike traditional image texture, procedural materials use mathematical functions to create texture on the fly. This opens up a universe of possibilities, offering scalability, adaptability, and ability to craft intricate designs without relying on external images. In Blender, we have a node-based system that lets us weave together these mathematical elements, giving birth to visual, stunning, and dynamic materials. Here we don't just create materials. Each node represents a specific function or texture element, and by connecting them like a virtual network, we sculpt our materials with precision and finesse. It's a visual symphony of nodes, where mathematical elements harmonize to bring our creative vision to life. For example, here I have already saved several materials that I created for my previous projects and that you should have seen in previous videos. There are procedural materials, the main difference of which is high customization. One material can be turned into another simply by using the settings that are all made in a group input. So, this procedural environment material are available on my Patreon for members as well for purchase. If you wanna support my channel and get this pack, I have all the link in the description. So, using procedural Blender texture, we can create a lot of necessary materials, the main features of which will be high customization without using image texture, no tiling, and the ability not to use unwrap. Just drag and drop material to necessary model, adjust some settings like scale, color, and done. Since we do not use image texture, the weight of the Blender file will be much less compared to the scene where image texture is used. Of course, procedural materials are not a total replacement of the image texture, and in some cases cannot do without them. Also, creating procedural texture itself takes quite a lot of time, but you can create your library simply by saving the materials made or using ready-to-use materials like mine or other artists, and significantly speed up your workflow. Create beautiful art and see you in the next video. Or don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button and share this video with your friends so that more people watch this video. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.